What's up, everybody? It's me, Dries Necronaut, and this is Dries News. Speaking of news, what about that revolt in Haiti? Anybody heard about that? Been willing to talk about that, but I kind of want to go to Haiti, but you know, be doing all this other stuff, they should not want to go. But whenever they stop all the foolishness and the price of bread to come down from like $17. I'll be over there next Thanksgiving. Shout out to my new subscribers. J. Aaron, what's up? Brothers of Travelers, what's up? Spec 20 Cent, what's up? What are my new subscribers? Who wants to start a live session? I ain't got no problem with that. We can start our own live session. Or you can join the live session with me and Rich Rich from the Sure Dominican Republic channel. Sunday at 9 p.m. That's Sunday at 9 p.m. Once again, shout out to my brother, G. Aaron. He wants in on the Medellin trip. No problem. I'll throw you into the little messenger group I have. It's pretty quiet right now, but once everybody touches down, they can reach back to the group and say, bam, I'm here. Bam, we going here tonight. Bam, my girl got friends. The people that are going to Medellin in the November time frame, I'm doing a group trip going to Medellin. Hit me up on my Facebook Messenger, August Hart. That's August Hart, Facebook Messenger. First, dog, you don't need 10K. I mean, unless you're going and investing some timeshares or some real estate or something like that. On a daily basis, what you buy? Food, drink, weed, you know, probably getting a little cheaper every now and again. But at best, man, you're looking at $100 a day. So unless you just stay in like 6 months, I don't think you really need 10K. You only need like 1,000. Actually, 5 days I'm going, all I need is 500. I'm gonna come back with change. Oh, and if you have a bank, that's in the. Do you know you got Visa stamped on your debit card? It will not give you your money. So, next time I go, my 500 I'ma have in my pocket. And just because I had 300 in my pocket when I went through Florida TSA, it gave me so much of a problem. Just because I had $300 bills, it gave me shit about going to Colombia. Like, who the fuck bringing dope to Colombia, you know what I'm saying? Anyway, I ended up taking a JetBlue from here to Fort Lauderdale. I ended up in motherfucking Medellin on the Spirit. You definitely don't need the stunt. You know, you're not in the matrix, so, you know, just be careful. Be conscious of your surroundings like that. Once you walk up the street on a dark night, and you're not looking over your shoulder, that's when the aura of the matrix has left. You don't have that weight on your shoulders like that. But just be conscious of your surroundings. Pretty much all you're doing is walking around with your eyes open just to be a normal person in Colombia. You know, relate to people. You know what I'm saying? Learn the language. Learn a little bit of their culture. Don't go out there trying to impose your will. You might end up with a Colombian necktie or something. If you don't know the language, of course, Google Translate will always see you through. It definitely don't bring up this. Like, when I talked about Colombia the first time, I didn't talk about Colombia to nobody I knew until I got back from Colombia. They up there trying to say, oh, don't go to Colombia. They doing this, they doing that. Well, if I walk outside, guess what? They doing this, they doing that. I might as well go to fucking Colombia. But you don't need 10K. You don't need the stunt. You need to relate with people. Use your Google Translate, you have to. And don't bring up none of the history that's bad, because you might end up with a Colombian necktie. And drink aguila beer. Presidente is cool. But see, them fucking aguilas is off the chain. And that's how you carry yourself in Medellin, Colombia. This is Dreams. Jedi.